Hello everyone, this is Gali and welcome to a new episode of How to Draw Dragons. Today we're going to learn how to put muscles on our dragons. And although this might seem like a simple thing to do, or maybe not, you have to think about what dragon you want to do because, well, they're based on animals. So we're going to try to base our dragon in a different animal. So for this I will just create a random custom sized canvas in Photoshop, and I don't know, zoom in enough to see our picture, and I will grab just my maybe a round hard brush, and for the sketch I will grab a light color. So what I recommend you do is you search for animal muscles, and for example here we have like a dog, a horse, and a cat. Even a camel might work, a hyena, I don't know, grab whatever you think might work. So as you can see, every animal has different and similar muscles. So for example here, in the ribcage, you can see a very similar design here. And on the cat, well, this one is very caricaturistic. So I might grab a different one. Try to find images that show the most realistic reference as possible, so you don't get a little confused. So yeah, well, we see a very similar thing here in cats. The differences, of course, are maybe the tails, how the hind leg work, how the neck is as long as short in different creatures. If we went for birds, we will get very different musculature. And some bird muscles. So yeah, like we see how thin their neck is, how different compared to a horse, how the legs are different, how they have wings. So that's our basis. We have to start somewhere, so our somewhere will be looking at different muscles and kind of trying to understand them, even with humans. If we drew every single muscle in every animal, we would never finish this video. So I'm just going to make one dragon, or two, based on this, these things. And I will also make a beautiful recommendation. Her name is Cyril. Cyril Whitledge, this woman here. I admire her so, so much. She has a background in biology, and she is a creature designer and concept artist. She creates beautiful creatures based on already existing creatures. I was trying to show this one, see? This one, of course, doesn't exist, but if you can see, she based this on real, already existing anatomy, maybe mixing fish with horses and everything. And if you can get a book, I will truly recommend getting her books. She has 5, I think, or one of them is coming. I think this one is coming. Just look at the beauty. So yeah, this is what I'm talking about. When you create your animals, you have to have in mind fantasy comes from reality, and she does this very, very well. So please get her book if you really want to learn how to blend your creatures to fantasy. Well, she's a star and she's very good. There are also many more artists like her, but she's one of my inspirations from, like, to draw creatures. I love what she does. So well, back to our design. We can grab maybe a better looking reference. It's a wolf. Oh, a bear. This is from one of her books, I believe. I do believe this is one from Terrell Whitledge. Maybe it's not, but she does this beautiful drawings. So well, we started with our Photoshop file. I don't know if I copied. Yeah, I did. Good for me. So you're using this as reference. You're not drawing it. So you want to get an idea. Like, for your dragon, obviously you won't do a bird, but if you wanted a long-necked dragon, you would start with like the head, obviously, and maybe a long neck like this, thin and long and made bigger here. And obviously the body will be different. So what would you do if you did not want a chicken body on your character. Well, you go back and grab another animal. Maybe you want it to look like a horse, or I don't know, a dog. We did find a dog before, so we're going to copy this one. Go back to Photoshop. Oh, good. They're here. So we might make this a little bigger. So we see that the muscles are different in this case. For example, he has a thick torso. Thicker than the chicken, maybe not, but then you will draw like the legs, and if you want legs that are longer, you can obviously look at other animals. I will stick with this one. So I'm here right now. Well, you cannot see it because it's on top. This. I'm here. So you see we have this part. And this part, just like the hips. And we're just gonna do a rudimentary drawing of the legs because we're not gonna draw them all. But we can base ourselves on this. Okay. Yeah, well, it's good and fancy, but what will happen if I want a dragon and not a chicken dog? Well, funny that you ask. We were doing a video about muscles. We're still doing a video about muscles. And the thing about making dragons out of animals is that you are not making a chicken dog. You are making a way more interesting thing, I assume. So, the point of grabbing images as reference is precisely that. You reference and then you change and alter the things you're doing. So you might hide that and go and edit what you're doing here. So, this thing doesn't want to grab my Dragosaur. Grab my Dragosaur. Okay, perfect. We're just gonna do the base of our Dragosaur. So you make a new layer on top of that. Maybe make this maybe lighter. Like that. And we're gonna start a practice on muscles. I don't know if I want to change my brush, maybe not. Maybe you still want reference, that's good. How to place the muscles on a dragon. Unless you want to draw a dragon that looks like a muscle creature, I suggest you don't get overboard looking at every single detail and trying to copy every muscle the way you see it, because it won't work. What I would suggest is like grab the shape of the muscle that you already have. Like if you want the neck, do the outside. And then if you saw the chicken here, how this muscle overlaps on top of this one. And then how, for example, this one is big enough and thick enough that it doesn't even have like a different shape. And the little bell you hear is my dog, so don't worry if there's like a magical bell around. Yeah, like you're just gonna mark a little bit of the muscle. You're not going to mark everything. Okay. So, if I were to draw the wings, I will maybe make this longer. And notice that this is a muscle connecting to here. So what you would do is just like trace this little part here. What I want you to do is not draw like me or copy what I do. Just understand why you're doing what you're doing, and that's going to develop into your own style one day. So if you just draw like me, well, that won't be fun, and I wouldn't be a good teacher telling you to draw exactly like I do, right? So to draw the things, you have to have a previous understanding of some things. We understand that this muscle will connect to the top of the wing here, you know. I will hide the chicken now. Okay, so we were on the lines and now we have our dog, which I'm gonna move here. So now that we have our chicken leg thing, you will see the muscle on the dog, it's a little different. Or the arms. So it has a very long muscle here. Well, not very long, but you know, this one. And then it goes down. And the top part, it's rounded. Should be like this part. What to do with all these muscles here? Well, for starters, this might not show unless you lifted the shoulder up. It's connected, so it's just a jumble of muscles you're not going to draw. What I would do is like copy, you know, the muscle shapes, you understand? And then just try to simplify what you see, don't draw everything. So there, for example, we go to the ribs. If you try to draw all this, well, it's just a simple shape. It's like you have the square here and then, you know, square like this, the shape. So you just go and try to understand. For example, the arm, from this part of the arm, this muscle goes this way. It goes upward, and you will have like this white, piece here, you know. And from, obviously the dog does not have wings, but you have to take that in mind. You're making a chicken dragon. So you do want to have a little more liberty when you draw. So remember, you don't really have to draw everything. So maybe just with a little line like this might be fine to understand. And if your dragon has scales, well, then there's no point on really drawing that, except to show that the dragon could have, like, I don't know, a plated armor like this. And little scales like that. I don't know, you can have freedom with that, but it's fine. So that's how you add muscles to any creature release, to look and reference and understand what you're doing. If you don't understand, then hardly are you going to be able to create your own creature. And this apparently doesn't work. Okay. So we were going to make the wing. We're gonna like connect it from here, you know, to here. And well, I have other videos showing you how to do that, so we're not going to do it here. As you can see, I did not go overboard doing the muscles. I just grabbed references and just traced a little bit of what the muscle will look like. You don't have to draw every single detail you find, if not you will never end. And every pose you have your character in will change a little bit. Just understand the basics and how muscles work. Some of them pull, some of them contract. Some of them get stronger. When they're stronger, they're bigger or thicker. And in every animal, they serve the same function, but they look different sometimes. So if you want your dragon to have realistic animal anatomy, look for the animals you want to draw. If it's a cat, dog, a horse, whatever it is you choose to do, dragons are based or are mixes of other creatures. There's nothing wrong in looking for animals to reference. That way we improve our drawings. We don't have to guess everything. If I try to do a dragon not knowing what muscles look like, I might end up doing very weird things, making them look kind of strange. Maybe not even working. If I wanted to do a super thick neck and I just did like one muscle, and then for the arms, I like did this super muscly arm, and then this looks weird. It looks weird because it doesn't even follow rules. What muscle looks like that? And there's some drawings I know that look like that, and I will show you just one, because it's a very perfect example. Let me see if I can find it like this. Nah. I don't know if it was Batman or it was Superman. I think it was Superman. I don't know. I'll look for it. I'm not sure this is the one, but whatever, you'll see this. Like, I'll just show you. It's kind of funny. Wait, how do I open the image? Okay, here. So, my friends, just bask in the beautifulness of weirdly placed muscles. Ta-da! If you haven't drawn humans before, you might think this is quite normal, but it is not. Some of these muscles don't even exist or don't even look like this. And though it is a very cool picture, I must admit, it looks very strange. He looks like a balloon animal. And that's my point when I say try to reference first. Because although he does look kind of strong, he also looks like he's got a lot of bee stings and he's swollen. He looks weird. And this is not the only one. There are so many other examples of this kind of thing happening. If I just found them now, I would die. But yeah, you can see this looks more normal. Or maybe this one. So that looks more normal, right? Than this. Okay. So I hope I made my point with that. With Batman, poor Batman. So yeah, unless you want to make very crazy and strange looking dragons, I suggest you do find your references and understand what you do. This has been all for today. Thank you for watching, guys. More videos to come. Subscribe if you like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.